Although it looks like the game is done except sounds, we still can't see what items we have collected so far, and we can't choose which of them we want to use in a given moment. That means it's time to add a simple version of equipment bar. To clearly see the equipment bar, which is going to be dark, we need to disable scene 0 and enable scene 1. And it would be also a good idea to go to the game manager and set active local scene to 1. Previously it was 0, and now as we play the game we will start with scene number 1. It will make things way easier to test now. Oh, and as we are here we may move the scene 0 above the scene 1. That would make sense. Equipment is a part of UI system, so let's go to the UI and let's add a new canvas. Now we need to change its render mode to workspace and use the main camera there, and also change its size. Let's set width to 1, height to 1.5, and about the position, I think we will start with the center of our screen, so it will be 8.9 and 5. Alright, let's go to the scene view and let's move this bad boy a little bit up to make him on top. And I think it's perfectly swapped and I don't need to round anything here, so if you have any other values than those two, you may change them to 8.9 and 9.25. I don't know why, but the name didn't save, so I need to change it again. And as it's done, we need to add a new image to our canvas. Let's make it almost as wide as the game screen, so it will be 16.5, and about the height, just the same as our canvas, so 1.5. Now it's time to go to color of this image and set it to black. And we also need to make it a little bit transparent, so let's change its alpha to 128. Or maybe a little bit smaller value, let's say 100. It's just how I feel about it. Choose what you think is the best. As you may guess, this is our main object of the equipment, so let's change its name to equipment. Now let's create a new child object of it, and it will be UI image. We need to make a little square out of it, so let's change its dimensions to 1.5 by 1.5. Now to change the anchor, we need to click this icon, hold Alt key and choose this icon. Now we are anchored to the left. And this is our item slot, so let's change the name of it, and we also need to change its color. For now, let's just make it totally transparent. Okay, and as we got it, we may go to this item slot and create a new child object of it, and it will be another image. Now, because it is a child object of it, we will hold Alt key and choose this option. That way we are going to always cover the whole area of this item slot. And this bad boy is our item image. And as we got it, we need to go to source image and look for something that looks good as a default image. Oh, those look awful. Maybe this, no, this. Oh, this looks like something that we can use. But we need to change it a little bit to make it more visible. Basically, all we need to do here is to change this image type to simple. Now, as you can see, this image is way bigger. For now, it looks like everything's fine, but as we go to the sprite selection and we click, for example, this water bottle, it is really tiny and we can't change it anyhow. The problem is with this sprite itself, and let me show you that. As we zoom in, we can see that this water bottle is actually that big. Now we need to cheat a little bit. Let's find a free spot, let's say over there, and create a new box. Let's move it closer to the bottle and let's adjust its size here. Now let's zoom in and make sure that we have at least one pixel of a free space around this object. Unity may do something weird with our borders, so we better keep it like that. Hit apply and close the sprite editor. Now let's go to item image and let's choose this new water bottle sprite. And as we can see, it's fake. If you think it's too much and you want it to look normal, you need to use preserve aspect. Great, I think this part is done, and in the future we will need a way to store those new sprites. And I think we will use some kind of array and an additional variable to store a default image for our empty slots. And also in this item slot we will need to add a new component, event trigger. The game will select the item, show the name of the object we want to click, and hide the name tag as the mouse is no longer above the item slot. And I think we can quickly add this function just before we end this video, so let's go to the name tag canvas, let's grab it and put it here and use this game object set active and leave it as it is. This box isn't checked, so that means we will have this game object set inactive. That's not the first time we do something like that in this project. Santa UI image has something very similar. And after everything is done here, we will have one pretty good preset of our item slot, and we will be able to duplicate it as many times as many slots we need in our equipment bar. We won't need to set everything over and over again, and this will be great. You know what we are going to do in the next episode. Have a good day and see you soon!